What is happening? I am rocking it solo. It is Monday, April 18th. We got MLB games as of now to talk over. I just dropped the members only, so this is the public for everyone to see. Got guys, including I want to discuss, switching it up a little bit. Got three tournament guys and two cash guys to talk over. If you want more, go check out the DFS 5-pack. The members only video just dropped. We'd love to have you sign up. Before I have to hop into the video, I'm going to shout out our promoter real quick. And the promo code will be in the description section of the video. A bunch of people sign up and win money already. So I encourage everyone to check them out. No harm, and I would appreciate it. So with that being said, let's talk over the slate tonight. Again, five guys, four players, one pitcher. I love baseball. So even with a little bit of weather out there, I'm not going to phase one bit. So let me share the screen and we'll roll. All right, so pitching options tonight look a little better from a distance than when you really start to analyze them. Frankie Montas can be really chalky, and he deserves to be. Just a pricing error. There's no reason for him to be that cheap in a really good spot. It's Baltimore. He's easy to kind of wanted to step outside the box a little bit and talk about a guy I really like in tournaments, and that's going to be Aaron Nola. Sure, it obviously comes with some risk. He's expensive in a tough spot in Colorado against the Rockies. That's why he's not going to get any ownership. Projected for a little bit under 5% right now. He's just too good to be that low owned. He's had good success against Colorado, both home and away. I'm not afraid of this Rockies lineup. People automatically see that he's pitching in cores and won't go there. Phillies need Nola right now with Wheeler looking a little bit shaky. Again, very risky. I would only go here in tournaments, but in tournaments, I like him quite a bit. Let's switch over to cash games. I'll talk about the cash game guys first because it's pretty easy. They're both of Aaron Nola's Phillies. Can't really get too much Philly exposure in cash games, and I think you want to start your lineups with both Real Muto and Bryce Harper. The top projected two guys as far as ownership goes on the entire slate. Real Muto at a pretty, I don't want to say weak, but weak-ish catcher position. Just stands out as clearly the top option. DK's doing you no favors, pricing these guys pretty high up. But with Montas so cheap, you can fit, you know, at least these two high-priced guys, probably a couple more. And again, Real Muto in cores against the weak righty and Chad Kuhl. Fade him at your own risk. Fade him at your own risk in tournaments and cash games. Lock him in and move on. And then Bryce Harper, same thing, but probably even more of a lock. Double digits in 4 or 5. 20 plus in 3 or 5. Dude's rolling right now. When he gets like this, he's a tough fade. And he's a tough fade tonight. In tournaments, I could see using him and kind of getting different elsewhere. He's a priority in cash games. Him and Montas are the two first guys you're starting with probably in those formats. Let's talk about a couple guys I like in tournaments. So one is going to be Jeremy Pena. I've been high on this guy. Looks like he stepped in admirably. Carlos Correa. They didn't want to pay him. They didn't want to pay Correa the money that he wanted. Pena, one of the top prospects in baseball, one of the top Houston prospects, if nothing else, has been really good, like I mentioned. I like Houston quite a bit today as far as the low on stack goes. I know Lorenzen was really good last time out, but we've read this book with him before. He's got good stuff, but he doesn't always put it together. So I think Houston at really low ownership is worth a shot in tournaments tonight. And getting a starting shortstop has some pop, some speed upside at 3,200. I'm all about it, and he fits well in that wraparound stack. Last but certainly not least, probably my favorite bat on the entire slate, Grisham. I like the Padres as a stack. I don't love them. I actually get both sides of this game in tournaments as far as San Diego goes from a batting perspective. And then Lodolo, if you want to take a cheap pitcher, also isn't the worst look in the world. Either way, I love Grisham here. Homered in his last at-bat on Saturday night, took 3 walks last night. Big buying signs here. I almost expect 2+ hits from him tonight with big speed slash power upside. Great price tag at 3,900. I'm all in on Grisham here. If I were making one lineup, he would definitely be in it. That's what I got for you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. A little bit short and sweet today, but I know some of you guys like that. If you have any questions for me, I'm around. If you want more info, more content, any of that stuff, go check out the DFS. We'd love to have you. Catch you guys on the flip side.